Blockflare, you guys are going to go ahead and come on up. Judges, give me a nod if you're ready. 3 minutes back on the clock. Go!
All right, so you're an internet business owner, and the one thing that you would obviously hate is people DDoSing your website. What I mean by that is hackers consistently attacking your website, trying to deny your service, so now people cannot go on and enjoy their favorite content media that you provide. Now, hackers do this by going on, taking and infecting hundreds of millions of personal devices and laptops, and use their aggregated network power together to go on and do their best to shut down your websites. Now, that sounds all really bad, but there's a good side to this. There are a bunch of centralized solutions out there, such as Cloudflare, such as Akamai Networks, and what they do is they do their best to mitigate DDoS attacks for your sake and for your business. But there's a little catch here. The opportunity costs, or exactly how much dollars in damage these sort of DDoS attacks actually provide, goes up to billions of dollars. AKA, the moment your online business gets hit by a DDoS attack, you're potentially losing millions to billions of dollars. And these guys, Cloudflare and Akamai Networks, in return to mitigate your DDoS attack, they also got to spend millions of dollars on their own servers. So what we want to do is find a little happy medium to that. And what we decided to do was make a decentralized, anti-DDoS, economically incentivized platform that's built on EOS. So how exactly does it work? Well, what we do, in comparison to Cloudflare, is we crowdsource together all the sort of commodity devices that all you guys have, and we'll pay you for your bandwidth for the sake of being able to mitigate all of these DDoS attacks. So simply, you register as a relayer over on EOS, and the very moment that happens, the typical DDoS attack happens by directly attacking a central server. So people don't typically are not going to be routing to a central server anymore. But with Blockflare, our platform, you're going to be routing all of your API requests, any kind of sort of website servers that you have, all through EOS through a single smart contract. So let's go on and show a little demo. So this is a little sample login. And you can see you've got a username, you've got a password. We'll go on and enter it. And you know, in a typical sort of login page, whenever you press that login button, it's going to be sending a request to a login credential server to verify that, all right, your username and password is correct, right? But the thing is, because you know that route, the hackers or potentially malicious people can use that, take advantage of that, and spam your centralized server of hundreds of millions of different nodes. What we do instead is we use EOS, the fact that they have a large amount of internet bandwidth, the fact that the supernodes in EOS collaborate with one another to perform consensus mechanisms, we'll take advantage of it as a DDoS firewall. And with that, we're not going to be routing any of your API requests, any of your account registrations, any important information through your centralized server anymore, but instead through EOS.
And time. Give it up. 2 minutes on the clock for you for any questions that you've got.
Yeah, so is it the block producers that are doing the routing or the individual devices that sign up on the EOS smart contract?
Right, it's going to be the individual devices alongside the block producers, actually, because it's a two-way defense. First is actually getting through the EOS firewall, I would say. And the second step is actually getting through the crowdsourced internet bandwidth.
Okay, so the crowdsourced internet bandwidth where people sign up their devices, that can in theory be done on a centralized website though. People can just sign up their IP addresses and other things, right?
Right. So what we actually do is we follow a good example of Tor, and what we do is we intentionally obfuscate the path that's taken between all of the sort of relayers, the ones contributing to bandwidth, so that you won't really actually know what sort of API server you hit to provide a response.
Awesome.
Can you elaborate a little bit more about the proof of work function?
Right, so upon every single request, every single route that's gone through EOS to mitigate DDoS attacks, before you can even make that request, you must complete a proof of work. Now think of it like this. If you got millions of network requests going through, obviously your server's gonna be crashing. But if you have to generate a proof of work, which takes some amount of time, 100 milliseconds, you're going to be going from a billion network requests being spammed to your servers per second by malicious attackers all the way forcibly down to 1,000 because proof of work, as we can see from Bitcoin and Ethereum, intentionally lets us bind the concept or notion or the physics of time into software.
So hackers can be extremely creative, as you know, and how would you try to hack the system that you've described?
10-second warning.
The way I would try to hack the system is try to take over the entire EOS network.
And on that note, time. Well done, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations. So, the first runner-up team, our second place team, the winner of $25,000 and one of those coveted spots at the grand finale. A warm round of applause. Blockflare, come on down!
I've been anticipating for this event for a long time, so it's been an honor for us.
I mean, it's just been amazing, like the amount of energy. I have no words to kind of just describe it.
Congratulations, guys.
We can't wait to be out there, going against everybody, seeing everybody internationally. We just really can't wait.
Blockflare, ladies and gentlemen.
US final, here we come.